Let's now talk to Attorney Antonio Lavinia. He's one of the UP law professors who expressed support for Justice Leonen. Good morning, Attorney, and thank you for joining us on the program.
Good morning, Christian.
Okay. This impeachment complaint filed against Justice Marvick Leonen, strictly from legal grounds, how strong or weak is this complaint against him?
It's very weak. There is really no basis for these complaints. No? The Sal-N complaint is based on newspaper articles. There is no proof. There is nothing that is alleged that is substantial about it. And the complaint about delay is laughable. Almost every justice present and in the past would have to be impeached if that ground was even given consideration by the House of Representatives, because it's about their caseload. And that caseload is not really dependent on them, but dependent on the cases that come in. And the responsibility for the delay is actually collective, but it's also institutional, in the sense that I've always said that to my students in constitutional law, that the system is defective in that the Supreme Court has to accept every case that comes to them. Unlike in the U.S., where the Supreme Court, you know, chooses only 50 to 60 cases a year.
But how about the
justices? Oh. Has 60 to 80 cases a week. A month.
Okay.
Enters the justices, each justices chambers.
How about the provision of the Constitution, which requires members of the Supreme Court to dispose of 37 cases in 24 months?
Yeah, well, those are what we call directory. Those are things that guide the court, and the counting of that as a technical meaning within the court. But as I said, that's if you follow that particular ground, which also is distorted, I think, because it's not. It's also not true that Justice Leonen has that kind of outputs. It doesn't count concurrences, it doesn't count dissents, it doesn't count a lot of the collective work that the justices do.
Okay, how about the third ground, arbitrary delay in resolving three HRET cases or electoral protests?
Again, that these things are collective decisions of not just the justices or even the chair, because he's now chair of the HOR HREP, no? But there are also members of the six members of the HREP that are congressmen or representatives. So that would be a collective responsibility, and again, it would be absurd to hold them accountable.
Okay. I mean,
no doubt, Christian, delay is a problem in all legal and judicial processes of the Philippines. But I think a serious constitutional and legal scholar would not blame individual justices or individual decision makers for that, but it's a systemic constitutional defect that has to be actually dealt with.
Okay.
So
despite the legal arguments that you raised against the impeachment complaint against Justice Leonen, we know that the impeachment process is also very political, especially here in the Philippines, and strange things have happened. Especially under this administration, or even in previous administrations, in particular under the Aquino administration. So how do you think this thing should be resolved now? And can this be construed as an unintended consequence, perhaps, of the 2012 impeachment of Renato Corona, the Chief Justice then, which also, of course, perhaps, which might have emboldened people in the next administration to also go after his successor, Chief Justice Maria Lourdes Sereno?
Well, yes, and I've always said that. I mean, I have not, I have had no qualms also about describing the Corona impeachment this way, the Co-Warranto case, and previously that impeachment of Chief Justice Serrano, and then now this one. And that's why it's important to really draw the line, because if this moves forward, let's be very clear. I mean, I've seen editorials to this effect. I have no evidence to that, but the sequence of this is that of this followed an inhibition complaint against him in the Marcos Robredo case, and where Justice Malyonen refused to inhibit, and the court refused to order him to inhibit. This follows the Co-Warranto case filed against him for at least the same solid grounds, and the Supreme Court had rejected that, and here we are again. Imagine, and this is the difference between the Corona case and the Serrano cases. In those cases, those were general complaints against the two chief justices, and don't have to rehash that. But the presidents in both cases did not like what those justices have done in several decisions in the case of Serrano, in interviews or speeches. The president didn't like that. In this case, it's not President Duterte, and I don't believe President Duterte is involved here at all. But this is a litigant. Imagine this, Christian. If it's a litigant that, you know, is after you and doesn't like your decision, doesn't like that you didn't inhibit, doesn't like the, you know, the way you're handling the case, then the resort is no longer with the courts, because then they tried with the courts, with the Supreme Court. The Supreme Court dismissed that, and then the resort now is going to be impeachment.
Yeah.
And unfortunately, the bar of impeachment is quite low. You know, more or less 100 representatives, not even a majority of representatives, are required for an impeachment case to go to the Senate. So I implore the House of Representatives not to let it happen.
Okay.
Because if they did that, it will happen again and again. And only because, and you know, the justices probably know this too, because it's quite clear, every time you decide a case against someone, doesn't have to be the president, you know, it can even be just an ordinary businessman, you know, they can, you know, do a lobbying effort, they can find someone to file an impeachment charge in the House of Representatives.
So basically, this can be used
to the system.
Yeah,
this harmful to the system, very harmful.
Okay.
Never mind Justice Leonen, you know, there, aside from the UP College of Law, I've also signed a letter and a statement by many of his colleagues before he became a justice for 20 years in the, you know, in the human rights and environmental area. And so Justice Leonen is fine. He is supported, he is loved by his colleagues, even if some of us might disagree with him some once in a while. But it's the system, it's the legal system, it's the judicial system that is truly, really under attack here. I don't even consider it a political point of view. I just consider it a threat to the legal system when you know, you're going to be attacked, the judge is going to be attacked for the decisions that you take as an individual justice.
Okay, Attorney Tony Lavinia, thank you for joining us this morning, sir.
Thank you, Christian. Thank you also to your audience for watching.